You can keep dwelling in that if you want to. You can keep talking negative about your husband if you want to. You can keep talking bad about your wife and your children if you want to. You can keep saying you ain't going to never amount to anything if you want to. You can keep telling yourself that you ain't never coming out of this if you want to. You can keep telling yourself that things ain't never going to get better for me if you want to. But when you just look at your neighbor, those of you who believe it, tell them I done flipped the script. Yeah, because whatever I confess, I now possess. I understand that life and death is in my mouth. I know I might have been speaking the wrong thing, but I done flipped the script, Sister Carol. I no longer, I now begin to possess the things of God. I know who I am in God. For God I live and for God I die. I shall speak the truth. I shall tell what I desire by God. And when I say I am lined up with the word of God, I am the head and not the tail. I am above and not beneath. I am blessed and I'm not cursed. So it doesn't matter what it might look like around me. I possess that I am a sanctified child of the living God. So I want the devil to know that it doesn't matter what the situation looks like right now. That because my faith lets me know that wherever I decree and I ask of God, it shall come to pass. Even though I might not see it right now, I'm holding on to my confession that I shall come out of it. I shall be healed. I shall be blessed. I shall be blessed. I shall be blessed. I shall be blessed. My house shall be blessed. My family shall be blessed. I decree I am. Come out of it. Look at your neighbor say, I'm about to get the strip. The solid rock I stand. On Christ, not my education. On Christ, not my political affiliation. On Christ, not my economic dispensation. On Christ, the living everlasting. On Christ, the white and morning star. On Christ, the bridge over the water. On Christ, the road of heaven. On Christ, the water bring up the moon. On Christ, my prayer when I'm hungry. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm flipping the script on my life. I got a new chapter. It can't be in my life. I got a new chapter. I'm flipping the script on my whole life. I shall be better than where I was. I shall be better than where I came from. I shall be better than where I am right now. I'm flipping the script on my life. Touch your neighbor again. Say, I'm not just gifted. I've been all in the journey. I've been all in the gifted. I've been all in the gifted. I got a new land on now. I've been all in the gifted ship over my life.
Whatever I confess, I now possess. Because I'm decreeing out of my mouth, I speak life over my life. Anything that's dead in my life, I speak life. That's some stuff in me that I allow the enemy to kill that needs to be resurrected. So I speak life over the dead things in my life. I don't know about you, but when you just tell your neighbor, I feel a pulse.
I feel a pulse.
Yeah, my dream was once dead, but I feel a pulse. My vision was once dead, but I feel a pulse. Yeah, all of my hope that I had in God was once dead, but I feel a pulse. Why? Because I just spoke life over a dead situation. My marriage, I feel a pulse. My children relationship, I feel a pulse
come out of life.
Life.
Over a dead situation. So wherever I confess, I now possess. There's no need for me as a child of God to walk in defeat any longer.
Yes.
Can I say this and I'm going to my seat? You are your own worst enemy.
Sure enough.
Because if you don't speak it of your own life, don't expect nobody else to. Some of you waiting on somebody to say something to get you going. Say something to get you moving. And they're not going to come. Because life and death is in your mouth.
That's it.
And if you don't speak something positive on your own life, somebody never will. And some of us may die waiting on somebody to say something that's going to change your life. It may never happen. But you got the power within your own mouth to say something in the midst of your condition that will change the course of your life. I choose life over death.
Yes, Lord.
Yes. I can choose to sit here and wallow in my past, all the past mistakes, all the past failures I had. I can choose to wallow in them. I can choose to revisit them. I can choose to go back and have that pity party, but I choose life.
Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
I would rather choose life.
Yes, yes. Amen.
And all I got to do is just speak it. And it's going to come forth. But if I choose to continue to make the wrong confession, I can never expect anything to be better for me in my life.
That's it.
Because a wrong confession don't show God's ability. It shows the devil's ability. A wrong confession gets the enemy's attention. And God will never show up where he's not wanted.
That's it.
A wrong confession will never allow God to show up in your life. God is just on the outside looking in. But he does not have the ability to come in. Why? Because your mouth didn't allow him to come in. We allow the mouth of one person to cause prayer to be taken out of school. While millions of those of us who profess Christ sat back and did nothing. And because the mouth of that one person caused prayer to be out of school, now we have allowed that spirit to keep prayer out of our house.
Help us, Lord.
And since prayer is not in our house, it has now creeped in the church where some of us just won't come and pray.
Help us, Lord.
And what that does is it gives the devil lordship. Because that was his program. That was his idea. And when we stop praying, we aid the enemy in his program. Because what it does to prayer, when you don't pray, it removes that shield, that defensive mechanism that God put in place. So the enemy can't mess with you. The enemy tries. He comes at you, but he bounces off you. Why? Because there's a magnetic shield that God puts in place because of your prayer. But when you stop praying, it allows that force field to be removed. And so when the enemy comes at you, he's able to penetrate you because the shield has been removed. Why? Because there is no praying going on.
Lord.
You're not protected. Because the shield has been removed. That's why he's hidden you from every side, because there is no shield to protect. Because when you pray, you're going to pray what God desires you to pray.
Yes.
And when you pray, it glorifies God. It don't glorify the enemy, it glorifies God.
Uh-huh.
So what he does is that he causes you to stop praying locally, individually. And because he stopped you praying individually, then you don't pray as a family. When he stopped you from not praying as a family, then you won't even come to church and pray.
Mm.
Then the enemy has got you right where he wants you, to where he wants to destroy you. But would you look at your neighbor one time again and tell them, I done flipped the script. Come on, stand with me. I often hear people say that, Bishop, I can't feel God. God is not a feeling, he's an experience. He's an experience. Why? Because feelings come and go. But experience is a lifetime. You need to have an experience with God. And you saying the right things out of your mouth calls you to have an experience with God like never before. It is my desire as pastor that every person in this ministry walk in victory.
Amen.
I don't want to say anything or do anything that would cause any member to turn their back on God. But I want to say things that would challenge you to understand the value that you have. Because if you don't know your self-value,